The dog didn't eat my homework. It would not hurt, Cody thought, to take one last look at his report on Benjamin Franklin, which he was scheduled to present after lunch. He had worked hard all weekend on those four pages, and even practiced reading it aloud to his big sister, Karen. Searching through his notebook, he realized the red folder was gone. Cody rifled through his stack of books, trying to make no noise while Catherine was presenting her report on Thomas Edison. "Are you okay?" whispered his friend Chelsea, who sat in the desk opposite. "I can't find my report. It was in my red folder. Have you seen it?" Cody muttered back. Chelsea looked around and shook her head. "Did you leave it at home? Or on the bus?" Cody felt a lump in his throat build. He had taken the report out and looked at it on the bus, making sure he had it. Had he set it on the seat beside him? He'd had the seat all to himself. The only person near him had been the annoying new kid, what's his name. If Cody had left it on the bus, it was that kid's fault for distracting him. He'd offered Cody gum. He'd tried to show him a baseball card autographed by his favorite pitcher. He'd told Cody that he had a really great climbing tree in his backyard and invited him to come over sometime to check it out. He seemed desperate to be friends. He even trailed after Cody when the bus dropped them off at school, calling, "Hey, Cody, wait up." Cody had pretended not to hear him and walked a little faster. "What seems to be the problem, Cody?" asked Mrs. Schmidt. "We need to give Catherine our attention." "Sorry, Mrs. Schmidt," Cody said. Chelsea shook her head at him. He was sure the folder had been in his backpack. It was the first long report he had ever had to write. Mrs. Schmidt required three sources, and he had been careful to cite them correctly. As quietly as he could, Cody delved into his backpack. It contained only a few pencils rattling in the bottom. "What can I do?" Cody asked his friends between presentations. "I can't find my report." "She'll think you didn't do it," Chelsea said, laying her own report about Frederick Douglass on her desk. "But I did it." "Really?" Cody's friend Travis said with a grin. "And it just vanished? That is so lame." "Cody! Cody!" came a loud whisper from across the room. It was what's-his-name, pointing wildly up at Mrs. Schmidt sitting at her desk. "What was this kid's problem?" Cody ignored him. "You could say your dog ate it," Chelsea said. "Mungo really does try to chew up your books." When Mrs. Schmidt called on him, Cody was unable to say anything, even a lie. He stood up and went to Mrs. Schmidt's desk, hoping he could whisper some excuse. "Oh, and here is your report, Cody," said Mrs. Schmidt. "Tristan Jenkins said he found it on the bus and turned it in to me. He said he tried to give it to you." "Tristan Jenkins?" Cody said, picking up his precious red folder. He turned and saw what's-his-name smile and wave. "Thank you, Tristan," he said aloud. "You totally saved me." Cody would not be forgetting his new friend's name again anytime soon.